Welcome back to the Michigan Business Beat, everybody. This is Chris Holman in our downtown studios at the Michigan Business Network in Lansing, Michigan. And please stop by sometime, see what we do here. It's kind of fun. Right now, we're going to venture across town, spend a little time with Carrie Rosengana. Carrie is the Chief Executive Officer of the Capital Area Mission Works, one of 16 Michigan Works around the state of Michigan, but the one that we know extremely well. And Carrie, as always, it's great to see you. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Chris. Wonderful to see you as always, too.
This is an important month for both of us. It is Women's History Month. So let's talk a little bit about why it's so important for employers and our community to address kind of the unique barriers that women in the workforce face.
Absolutely. So we really need to take a critical look at where we are at, women specifically, are at right now at this point in history. It's no doubt that we've seen some progress within our region and within our country towards increasing access to education and to well-paying jobs for women. But we also know there's a lot further that we need to go. According to a 2020 Women in the Workplace report, since 2015, we've only seen modest signs of progress in the representation of women in the corporate pipeline. So for every 100 men that have been promoted to a management position, only 85 women were promoted. So there's some differences there that we see at play. And as a result, women remained significantly outnumbered in those entry-level management positions at the beginning of 2020. They held only 38% of manager-level positions compared to 62% for men in those same positions. So gender inequality exists in our country and in our region, and we as leaders really need to continue these discussions and be intentional to look for opportunities to change where we're going in the future.
And, you know, on top of that, then you throw COVID-19 in to the mix, right? And that's had a real impact on women in the workforce.
It really has. The COVID-19 pandemic has really had the power to undo decades of progress that we've made towards gender equality in the workforce. We know, according to that same report I just mentioned, that 1 in 4 women are considering either downshifting their careers or entirely leaving the workforce due to COVID-19. That's a really significant number, 1 in 4. Taking that one step further, we also know, and we're failing to acknowledge oftentimes, that women losing their jobs are primarily women of color. It's essential that we're recognizing that all women are not experiencing this pandemic dynamic in the same way that others may be. We know that some of the biggest factors, according to that report, that are leading to an employee's decision to downshift or leave the workforce can be a lack of flexibility at work, feeling like they need to be available to work at all different hours, housework and caregiving burdens aligned with COVID-19, worrying that their performance is being negatively judged because of the caregiving responsibilities that they have at home, and feeling unable to really bring their whole self to work. So experts underestimate they really may truly not be able to measure that impact of COVID for at least another year. But in the meantime, we know that women are struggling, and they're struggling to make ends meet and meet the balance between work and careers in the workplace.
So what do employers do? I mean, how do they encourage and support working women?
I think we really need to start by looking inward at what our processes and our expectations are. Have we changed how we've been doing business since the pandemic hit? And have we communicated what that looks like to our employees clearly? So helping them to manage their expectations on productivity and workload can also help our employees be able to turn off during non-business hours and on the weekends, which is really critical for that work-life balance. And setting and then reinforcing that expectation continually is really important in the workplace too. We also can look at what are some of those benefits that can help with some of the biggest stressors, which are money. Can we support our employees by adjusting leave plans, reimbursing childcare, and encouraging the utilization of existing flexible spending accounts and things like that to help them know where those resources are? And most importantly, I would say we need to check in on our employees. According to that report that I mentioned, Black women are less likely than women overall to report to their manager, has inquired about their workload, or taken steps to ensure that they're feeling like they have the supports they need. And only about a third say that their manager has fostered an inclusive workplace in the workload. So we want to consider that we need to just check in on those employees now more than ever, and our coworkers, and that can really make all the difference in the world right now. It will give us insight to what their needs are and make sure that we are addressing where we can offer those supports in any way possible.
Yeah, well, it certainly is something that needs to be addressed. And I might throw in there also that sometimes it's cost effectiveness that comes in, that the cost of childcare,
yes,
to go to work is so close to a wash, you know?
It is, it truly is. And then we've seen that all too clearly now with childcare being such a hot topic right now. The cost there can be prohibitive and have to make some of those decisions really challenging.
Yeah, so there's a lot of challenges out there, as you say, but it certainly is important for us to pay attention to those and not make the mistake of ignoring a very valuable portion of our workforce too, people who are great contributors, you know?
Absolutely.
All right, well, listen, Carrie, thanks so much for being with us as always, and thanks for the great work that you do. Thanks, Carrie Rosengott is the Chief Executive Officer of the Capital Area Michigan Works here in Lansing, Michigan. Thank you, Carrie.
Thanks, Chris.
All right, we're gonna be right back on the Michigan Business Beat, brought to you on the Michigan Business Network. I'm Chris Holman.